Last spring, Texas was looking at a possible 12-day summer snapper season in federal waters, the shortest in history. But after several lawsuits and political threats, the courts decided on a 28-day season for all Gulf states. But then federal fisheries managers said snapper stocks were healthier than previously thought, so they suggested adding as many as 21 fishing days in the fall. Then fisheries managers said we caught more snapper than the quota allowed, possibly jeopardizing the fall season.
What are you doing, Scott?
You're releasing a red snapper with a sequelizer, barotrauma release device.
Tell me what it does.
We're gonna put that fish back down to his natural atmosphere where he came up from. And bring him back to life.
So you got a weighted gadget down there that at certain depth will release automatically, right?
Yep.
And it just did?
Release it 50 foot, it'll release
at 50 feet. So that's one live fish, huh?
Yep.
It was bloated when it was on the surface, but it's
totally full of gas. Instead of poking a hole in that fish and killing him with a hole in him, we took him back down to his natural depth and released him, and that fish is gonna live.
In the end, we got our fall season, but only 14 days, starting October 1. About a week into the season, I boarded a 36-foot contender powered by three 300 horsepower Yamaha engines belonging to Galveston Captain Scott Hickman. We screamed into the Gulf at nearly 60 miles an hour and had no trouble catching 8 limits of big red snapper. Then we caught a fair share of kingfish along with some sharks. The weather was about as comfortable as it gets, and the catching was easy. October is definitely for snapper fishing.